The first thing, stepping with your legs turned out, you have to, on the second count, really get around this much, really around, but don't let this leg creep forward so it stays to your side when you open. Now you close up for the next part. You're this way, then you close, and you do the last thing this way up. So you open this way, really out. You have to get your leg around without bringing it forward. In other words, you have to hold on in your gut and bring your leg around to the side. Let's do it once more. One, two, three, go, and. Yes, yes, yes. Circle is something you can do, and a circle can be small or big, or it can be circuitous. But a circle, I think, is one of the, well, you even see it when you see animals surrounding a prey. That it's almost like a circle, you know, they make, because they've come at this from different angles. And instead of it being a line, it does something where it completes itself. I wanted everybody to come in, that is, not to be on the stage. I thought, well, maybe we could all come in from the same place. Then I thought about different ways of doing that from the side. And then I thought, I wonder if we could come in from the back, one at a time, or sometimes two. And then, that began the construction of the continuity. So I decided, well, I'll come in first. It was a piece that I did first, and now Robert does, but we've tried to keep it as close as possible.
I was really surprised when I came out for Sounddance and the audience was so close. And I had, I had performed Sounddance since 1995, I think. And when I was so full of angst the first years that I performed it. And I, you know, because I was so excited and so severe. I was.
Well, I've been working at Garnier with the French Opera Ballet oh, I think it was about 2 months. And it was a difficult situation. What I gave was so unfamiliar to them on almost any level that they had great difficulty. First of all, the idea of not dancing with the music to keep you together was for a number of them extremely difficult. When I came back, I was looking forward to working with my company and decided to start something as soon as I could. So I began to work on Sounddance. I had asked David Tudor if he would compose a work for it. And I think the only thing he asked me was how long it would be, and I think I said under 20 minutes. And I asked Mark Lancaster if he would make something for this. And he did indeed. I don't know where he found the material, something that covered the whole back wall, not all the way to the top, but sort of halfway up this way. And this one entrance, which had it too had material which was cut so people could come through it. The rest of it was these heavy drapes of this, he told me where he got it and I forgot, but it looked like when he put it up, it looked like you were in some haunted castle. Well, briefly that way, with this heavy material hanging down, not draped incident, but just as though it had been there for years and had slightly changed its shape. So lively to come back to work with people who were not put off by the kind of thinking or doing, but rather eager to see what was going to happen. And I wanted to make something which had as much activity in it of different kinds that I could think of, ranging all the way from doing things on the floor to standing, to up. And I also didn't want them to almost ever dance together. That is, all do the same thing. There are a couple of times that happens, but there are, I think, only about 3 times when everybody does the same tempo at the same time. But I was trying to find movements that were abrupt and fast, and actions between the dancers that were almost like percussion, rather than, say, a legato kind of thing, even though there are some slow movements in it. I think it was mostly just trying to think about things that would be active. That's where I pull them, or like now Robert does. I wanted it not to be something polite.
I would call it almost joyous. It was, and I've gotten more like that as I've gotten older. So, and it's kind of a relief actually, because I, after being so serious and severe, it was nice to open up. And I, of course, having done it for so many years now, and being very proud, of course, to do it, because it was my favorite dance when I saw Merce do it. And the little things that go on in your mind as you're doing it are, really, you try not to be involved in your mind at all. You just want to let your instincts go and be sensitive to what's around you.
Julie, is there anything else you want to check? It looks good. There's one thing. When you're exiting, I think you're with Koji, right? You have to be sure you start with the leg going this way. This is the exit, yeah, right? It's that, just that you really get your leg, that's right, going back. That's right, yes, 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 yes. Is there anything else you want to try or check? It looks good, no? Is there anything, yes, yes, yes. Anything for the rest of you? Okay, then we have a break.